Red Solstice 2 Survivors is utterly and totally confusing. Nothing is explained and nothing makes sense. It's very niche, I'm not even sure what genre this is exactly. It has horrible elements such as the UI. It has fabulous moments like walking around with your squad in the beautifully lighted environments rendered by Unreal Engine. There's a sense of cooperation and fulfillment after killing and surviving tons of waves with random strangers in skirmish mode. But also there's a campaign you can play solo with some bots or with some buddies, and there's no storyline at all unless you go deep into the archives menu. This game is all over the place. It's like Iron Ward, the developer has separate departments for all these various game elements. Had everyone finished their work and then compiled the whole thing within a week without anyone looking at it since. And that's how they shipped the entire product. So let me try and make some sense of it all for you, which is honestly going to be difficult. And to be clear, I am not saying Red Solstice 2 is bad. It is not bad at all, but holy moly, this game would have benefited so much from a few months in early access. Okay, what is this game? I will mainly show you lengthy unedited pieces of combat missions because that is honestly the main game here. This way you get hopefully a bit of an idea on how this plays out without me explaining all the details of these missions. So let's start with the campaign mode. The story is pretty much non-existent, so it's hardly worth talking about. And I'm not even saying that there is a story but it's not well told, I'm just saying that there is hardly any story in the campaign mode. It is about Mars, overrun by mutants, and you need to stop them. Or reclaim the planet, or something like that. The way you play the campaign is best compared to XCOM 2. You have a base of operations, it's just a bunch of menus, and I will explain the menu tabs. There's the world map, which shows several sectors and how much infestation each sector has. More infestation means more difficult missions. You can spend intel to gather resources and save specialists, and you can do these missions. There's the facilities tab, which harbors some research, engineering, and upgrades. By spending resources, using specialists, and waiting for research to complete, you unlock more and more features. Similar to XCOM, you can capture and research mutants too, giving you additional perk points to spend. The archives would in any other game just be a codex or a bestiary, but here basically the entire game manual is here, as well as the story and lore. This is extremely helpful because the regular tutorial offers only like 10% of the game. In order to understand how Red Solstice 2 really works, you should really read this manual. Back to the campaign menus, however, we got two more to go. There's the profile, another menu full of upgrades which you need to unlock by leveling up your class. And that's a good time to talk about classes, I guess, because there are quite a few. You start out as a medic or an assault using an assault rifle, but you can also play as a demolition, a heavy support, marksman, and recon. Each class has distinct perks you can pick, as well as a general perk pool that you can choose from. The classes definitely add variety, because also those perks you unlock in the profile need to be equipped in the last menu tab, which is the armory. The armory features you and your suit. You're walking around in power armor pretty much, and the way you equip all sorts of buffs and abilities and health packs and whatnot is similar to how you gear up a mech in Mech Warrior. You have limited power supply, and creating a build is a mix between having enough power and equipping you useful and fun abilities, which can be either active or passive. You get to choose your weapons, of course, and there's a wide variety of weapons to choose from, and you can unlock more as you go. On top of this, there's a ton of customization. This part of the game is still utterly confusing, and it took me a while to figure out how this is all set up, and once again, the UI isn't helping at all here, clearly. But hey, once you get going, it is cool. I enjoyed tinkering with the suit, and as soon as you created your build, let's say, it is time to do a mission. Here is where the game differs from XCOM a lot. This is a real-time action combat game instead of a turn-based one. Everything else is pretty much the same, including an Overwatch function, but now it is real-time and it works beautifully. As soon as enemies enter the radius of the Overwatch, you just start shooting them. And this is probably my lack of game knowledge when it comes to this genre, but I can't remember playing a game like this pretty much ever. You're dropped into a big map, usually a destroyed city, and you get a few objectives. Rescue civilians, protect an escort, save a scientist, or nuke down a mutant hive. And while you're running around with the bots or with a bunch of friends you can invite via Steam, waves of monsters spawn in and start assaulting you. You can see the bar on top of the screen. This game starts out fairly easy, but it ramps up and the fights can get extremely hectic and a lot of fun. Initially, just enabling Overwatch and running around was enough to clear the missions, but soon The monsters keep piling up and they keep pouring in, and you need your entire arsenal to fend them off. It's great fun because the map offers a lot of interactive elements for your exploding needs to slow them down and blow them up like cars and gas pipes. Exploring abandoned facilities gets you ammunition and several consumables and other goodies, usually in the form of more explosives to blow up more stuff. In essence, it's about surviving and blowing shit up, which is a wonderful combination, to be honest. It is a shame then that the maps lack variety, and after 5 hours of playtime in the campaign, I've been doing the same missions and side quests over and over again. This stuff becomes repetitive real soon, and the only variety lies in the additional challenge, as the game gets progressively harder and you need to be more tactical and blow up more stuff in order to survive the onslaught. But that's the extent of it, honestly. There is not much else there. And after around 5 hours, I was getting very bored with the campaign, and I really didn't feel the need to do another mission. Which is really a shame, because the build-up and the whole feeling of these missions is well executed. The start is usually about exploring, and it's somewhat comparable to a Battle Royale start, where you're just scouring houses and locations for ammo, loot and gadgets to use while killing the occasional monster. As the waves increase in size, you're going to need to find a suitable location to defend, get preparations in order, set up a perimeter of defense with explosives, and once the wave comes in, go totally ham. It's utter chaos from time to time, and it's super fun. Looks good too, by the way. I love the Unreal Engine games because the lighting is so crisp, and they usually run flawlessly on my PCs, and this one is no exception. The music that swells up as the waves increase in number and difficulty is an original track, and you can hear that for sure. It doesn't disappoint one bit and really elevates the several action pieces Red Solstice 2 offers. I was talking to a buddy after this campaign about a game at this point, and I'm complaining a little bit about this campaign. I wasn't really sure what to make of it all. Try a bit of skirmish with some random players, he said, and so I did. Skirmish is completely different, honestly. Once you go into a skirmish game mode, the whole campaign stuff is obviously gone, but all new skill points and perk points are suddenly available. I'm assuming you would normally unlock these in the campaign by expanding your base and researching everything, but now they're all just there. That's cool because you can get all those perk points back at a small XP fee and repurpose your character for multiplayer, which I did. I then jumped into a random lobby, of which there are plenty, by the way, and before you know it, you're playing 8-player co-op missions. Now, mind you, these are still the same missions that you did previously, so there's nothing new here per se, but playing the game with 7 others, chatting about strategies, splitting up to find resources, do missions together, and in the end fighting waves and waves and waves of monsters. Yeah, I can see the charm all of a sudden. For example, if you want to enter a building in the campaign, you need to search for the door, unlock it, restore power. It's a bit of a hassle. In co-op, you just ask the demolition to blow up the building walls, and there you go. Suddenly, things start to make a little bit more sense. I'm actually someone who doesn't care too much about multiplayer in most games, and I'm more into story-driven campaigns and adventures. Red Solstice 2 simply doesn't provide this, at least not in a way that either makes sense or that is very enjoyable, to be honest. Especially solo, it is kind of boring. But playing skirmish, on the other hand, now it starts to get interesting all of a sudden. I played a whole heap of co-op missions, grouped up with tons of random other players, tried out a few more builds and weapons, spent more perk points as my classes leveled up, and I had a good time once again. But also, once again, it is very repetitive. And while playing this together with 7 others is a lot of fun and it runs surprisingly well, in the end you're playing those same few maps with the same missions and side quests. Skirmish is a lot more fun because of all the interactions, including people dropping a nuke on the map without you realizing you're in the blast radius, but I realized eventually that this game simply isn't for me. And I can't shake that feeling that if the game had put in a bit more effort to welcome new players to this experience and to optimize the UI, which is a big hurdle here, then my time and initial impressions would have been that much better. And it would have allowed me to get into the game so much easier, and maybe it would have hooked me, you know? First impressions matter though. It is a missed opportunity really, but the game already operates on such a small niche on the gaming spectrum that you can't afford those missed opportunities. Early access would have supplied a few more layers of polish, but early access is a risk as well. I understand that. Even after playing 10 hours, the main sentiment I have is confusion. That's impressive, actually. But I don't regret my time in the game. There are plenty of elements that make it worth your time and maybe your money, but you need to know what you're getting into. Hopefully, I've given you a little bit of an idea here. But is it worth your money? I got a review key from the developers. Thanks for that, by the way. But would I be happy spending 30 euros on this game? Probably not. But that's because this game isn't really a game for me. It's not because it's a bad game, because it is not a bad game. It's quite an enjoyable game. And if you enjoy creating all the builds, suiting up for another round, tinkering with the power armor, and you don't mind a bunch of repetitive maps and quests, but you're in for the thrill of the action and the waves of enemies, then you should probably give this a go. I feel the execution of the missions is very well done and it offers a very cool experience. But maybe wait a bit for either a sale or when the game drops some more patches and maybe adds a little bit of more variety. But that's it. That's basically all I have to say about Red Solstice 2. If you have any questions or remarks, put them in the comments down below. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did and you want more like this, consider liking the video or even subscribing. And if you really like the video and you want to support the channel, you can grab a YouTube membership for $2, which gets you absolutely nothing. It's just to show your love and support. You can also check out my Nexus store, link in the card and the description, where I'm selling a few of my favorite games. If you buy those, I get a small cut. This game isn't on there, but others that I would heavily recommend are. Thanks for watching and making it to the end. Love you all. See you soon. Bye-bye.